It's a year since Edgecumbe was flooded.
Yes,
and you'll remember the pictures. Horrendous, as hundreds of residents were forced from their homes. Many of those houses were ruined. Some are still being repaired.
And as is often the case, the rest of the country moves on, leaving those affected to get on with rebuilding their lives. Michael Holland's been back to Edgecumbe, where a well-known street artist has been hard at work doing a great job lifting spirits.
It was just a car park. But now it's so much more. The optimistic gaze of a young woman, a symbolic cleansing of the stain of an angry river inflicted on the people of Edgecumbe this time last year.
I see brightness, future.
How badly does this town need that message?
Huge. It tells a story. The story's in the eyes.
In the eyes of Vicky Richards' 16-year-old daughter, Nethia, her likeness captured by that master of the spray can, Mr. G.
I feel honoured to be up on the wall.
Everyone tells me you're quite shy, but you're now the biggest person in town. Right down to the stud?
Yep.
And a beauty spot?
Yeah, all my beauty spots.
The work entitled Hope, encouraging those rebuilding their lives after the flood devastation to look to the horizon. Nethia's family home, one of a dozen deemed beyond repair and removed from the area nearest where the Rangitaiki River breached its stop bank and forcing the evacuation of 1,600 people.
Heartbreaking, you know, because we were in our house for 22 years.
Everyone in Edgecumbe has had different ways of coping. For us, it was more around what we could. We can't do anything with our own homes, so let's go and help other people with their homes. So we dealt with it that way.
Of the 305 homes damaged, 212 have been reoccupied, with work continuing on the remainder. Although, just like Christchurch, stories emerge of residents continuing to do battle with insurance companies and shoddy workmanship.
Where there's opportunity, sometimes there's opportunists.
For the Richards, one of the toughest parts, driving past their red stick at home for 9 months before it was finally cleared from the site.
You know, I went past one day and I remember seeing my front door open. I wanted to run, jump over the fence and just close the door because it was a loved home.
1 year on, we're stronger. We are more hopeful. Edgecumbe survived the earthquake in 87. We've had a flood in 2017 and, you know, we breathe them tough here.
The town is doing good, really good.
Starting to hustle and bustle a little bit.
Hustle and bustle as much as a small town can.
That's right. A few toots on the tractors.
And if any locals need a pick-me-up, a certain young lady down the road just might help their spirits.
Come around the corner and I saw her eyes and I was, must be pollen in the air. No.
He's a softie. He's a softie, he is.
Beautiful eyes. An uplifting message too. Good on you, Mr. G. And don't worry, Dad, it seems there's been a bit of pollen in the studio as well.